Let us now study the phasor analysis of an inductor across AC EMF. Again, we have studied that when a time varying EMF, sinusoidal EMF is applied across an inductor, a current flows through it. But here, if we consider EMF in phasor form as E0 angle 0 degree and the inductance in form of inductive reactance as XL phasor, which is omega L angle plus pi by 2, then we can easily analyze what phasor current flows through the circuit. So here we can write phasor current in circuit is, in the situation it can be written as I phasor is EMF phasor by XL phasor by Ohm's law. And if we substitute the value, it is E0 angle 0 degree divided by omega L angle plus pi by 2. Then you can see current phasor here we are getting in magnitude is E0 by omega L and in division it will be 0 minus pi by 2, so it will be minus pi by 2. So E0 by omega L we can write as the peak value of current at initial phase angle minus pi by 2. So if we write as time function, we can write current as I0 sine of omega t minus pi by 2, where I0 is equals to E0 by omega L. You can see the time function is same which we obtained by using calculus and the Ohm's law applied across the given system. And here if we draw the phasor diagram for EMF phasor and I phasor, then here you can see on Argand plane EMF phasor can be considered at amplitude E0, magnitude E0 and in phase angle 0. And current in this situation will be lagging behind this EMF by an angle minus pi by 2. So this will be the current amplitude. And both are rotating, say, considered to be at an angular speed omega. And if E0 rotates at an angle theta, then I0 will also rotate by the same angle, such that always the phase difference between EMF phasor and current phasor is pi by 2. At every instant, the magnitude of EMF and current are out of phase by an angle pi by 2, with EMF leading or current lagging.